Ranching in the Sandhills, where cattle outnumber people.
You take the challenges that might exist any place with ranching, and then you put them out here and they're multiplied, right?
Yeah. A large percentage of cows in the United States are managed, is in these environments like this. And they're not always easy environments to manage as well.
Are animals healthy, eating enough? Where do you want them? We spent a day with researchers at UNL's Gudmundsen Laboratory, folks looking at what-if ways, using tech to make things more efficient for all cattle producers, especially those out here. So what if collars could give producers data about the cows wearing them and even help move them around?
So this is just a basic GPS collar. There's also an accelerometer on this collar that measures both the side-to-side, the forward and back, and the head-up and head-down motion on that animal.
That gives Stevenson lots of info. If a cow is eating, how much they're moving, important for tracking animal health. How cows and calves interact with each other. Where they're eating, and how that impacts what they're eating.
You want to be able to tell if they're spending too much time, for instance, in one area, and what you can do to get them to other areas.
Right, it makes for a more efficient grazing management if we're able to utilize an area more uniformly. This is our virtual fence collar that we have. Mm-hmm. So this ties into being able to put that virtual fence out on a landscape.
Similar to invisible fences for dogs, it could cut down on the amount of time ranchers spend checking and fixing fences and help with rangeland management by letting them easily move animals to different pastures remotely.
And you could map out where those fences are on a computer program. And so what happens is that cow goes towards the fence, it hears an audio cue, and oftentimes they get used to the audio cue knowing, okay, I can't go any farther. If they do proceed, then it gives them a mild shock to turn them back.
So when you look at the big picture of producers that raise cattle out in parts of the world like this, how does all this that you're doing with collars benefit them?
That's kind of our goal here is to utilize this technology and tie it into the overall landscape management within an area.
What if 3D imaging, adapting a camera from the video game world, could help producers know what their cows weigh? That's what Ije Zhang is working on.
So right now, you're just running a lot of cows through here so you can capture images, then capture the real weight, and begin to build sort of a database, essentially, of different sizes and shapes of cows and what they should weigh based on your imaging. Is that accurate?
Exactly. And we have run, I think, more than 240 cows or heifers already. So I wanted to see if using some newer gaming cameras can actually help them do the job.
So how does this help a producer knowing on a regular basis how much the cow weighs? Why is that important?
If a cow is overweight, that is not good because that means probably the cow is being overfed. But if it's way too skinny, that is also not good because it's probably gonna have a lot of reproductivity issue or that she's simply just sick. So knowing the body weight will be really helpful for the producer.
Ranchers could eventually set up cameras and capture images of cattle where they're at, maybe above a water tank in a remote pasture, identifying problems sooner with fewer resources.
Video game technology in the animal science world.
Yep, you will never know what kind of possibility we can see. If I can provide something that producers can really see benefits and to reduce their, you know, daily time and maybe in the long run it will be cost-wise, that will be the biggest thing I enjoy for my work.
What if there was a way to automatically control how much cows eat? First, the problem. Cows need supplements to the grass they're grazing on. These feeders provide that. But different cows behave different ways.
And so what generally happens is you have the more aggressive cows eating 3 to 4 to 5 pounds of that, and the timid cows may not get a thing.
The solution? Automation, giving cows just what they need, guided by individual electronic ear tags programmed by the rancher.
If you've got this tag on your cow, and this cow needs feed, and you want it to have however much, this will trigger Once it gets close,
right.
That opens.
That opens.
They stick their head in.
Yep. And as soon as it gets to that amount, it closes and it can't get back in there, right?
Lock. For ranchers, saving time plus the costs of fuel to refill feeders and wasted feed.
And so it really can help control that cost and decrease that variability in animal performance due to under or over consumption.
A bonus, a cow stepping up to eat is also standing on a scale.
And so it provides me an avenue to get daily body weight that's very tough to get in a grazing setting.
So lots of interesting what-if stuff here. Things close to implementation, some further away, all looking at the future. In an industry Mullenix says is sometimes slower to embrace change.
There's always resistance because of some of the ideas that we've always done it this way. And so with any industry, there's always early adopters and there's people that don't adopt. And you know, it's always the early adopters that progress and move forward and willing to take chances on stuff. And so understanding where they can fit and where they don't fit is very important. The Ranch of the Future is just a concept of how can we move forward and utilize and embrace some of these newer technologies as they come out. We can take that to a producer and say, look, you know, this works great under the circumstance. If you don't have this, I would not try it. So that's kind of the concept of how can we move forward and embrace technologies that can really help or be a test bed for technologies that may or may not help.